certain level of fear and anguish simply because of the acts committed themselves. In the report, a number of these tortures and punishments were carried out on the accused. The application of terror consisted in the tying of the hands behind the back, followed by twisting for a considerable time, with a sudden release and drop the victim just around the corner. These people are problem gifts, sometimes with good sex qualities, often dislocated mountains of the shoulders. The stun gift was a mental anchor binding the leg in such a way as to draw the bed by the insertion of wooden wedges between the flesh and the anchor. The resulting increased pressure caused some sort of skin. Such beliefs, which were not explicable in any rational manner. There were occasions when sometimes one saw the opposite object. Fear of the evil eye remained strong amongst the population, so that people ended up resorting to Muslims to help them. Slaves were amongst the most common choice. Talismans and amulets, effigies, and various other high objects were also used. Due to the affinities which developed between the slaves and the inhabitants, there was an increase in the number of superstitious objects, potions, and writings. There were also instances of Satanism. Superstition was thus looked upon by the authorities as an illness which would prove contagious if left unchecked. To report it by the Holy Roman, the tribunal of the Inquisition was abolished. The French government commission, at the end of its sitting, held on July 13, 1798, it had wished it, and it has been done. His presence was enough to demoralize and to put to flight your tyrants, and to deliver you from the absurd and oppressive yoke of the treble jurisdiction, inquisitions, bishops, and orders, under which you were groaning.
Commonly known as the Inquisitor's Palace.